This is Grace Notes. I'm Alan Button, and pleased to have as our guest today, Janette Rod. Janette, welcome.
Hi, thank you for having me here.
Janette, just by way of initial introduction, is the founder of an organization called Mama's House, based in Fuquay, but with outreach to really anyone that has need. Have I got that right,
Janette? That is correct.
And you have a bachelor's degree in finance from Florida International University.
Yes.
Tell us a little bit more about Mama's House.
Mama's House was founded in August of 2018, and it was founded on the purpose to serve anyone that had a legitimate need with food and clothing and housewares and any kind of item that was necessary. I founded Mama's House at the age of 45 because I decided that I wanted to do something meaningful with my life. And though I do have meaning because I'm a mom and a wife and I have my career, I wanted to do something with my past experience to be able to say my life just wasn't in vain. What I went through didn't have a meaning. And I know that there's a lot of need in our local communities. And I wanted to form a charity that would be very hands-on, very transparent, very open to people, and that they wouldn't feel pressured to have to do anything or abide with anything, just that if you have a need, you could come over to Mama's House.
It is a 501c3 organization,
is that
right?
That is correct.
You also, Janette, mentioned Mama's House as having some connection with your own experience and background. Why don't you tell us about that?
I was a dumpster diver from a very young age, basically from the moment that I can remember. And since I struggled with eating food from the garbage, and basically all my clothes came from clothing bags that was always used, I didn't really have toys as a child.
And you grew up where, by the way?
I grew up in Lansing, North Carolina.
Which is in Ashe County.
It's in Ashe County.
Very northwest part of the state.
Yes, in a very rural part.
In the mountains.
In the mountains when we had dirt roads back then. And life was difficult. We didn't have any heat in our house, and our windows were broken, and transportation we would lack of, and it was just an all-around extreme poverty. That's the only way that I can put it. And I decided, basically, instead of constantly grieving and focusing on the negative, I decided to implement as much time as I could in school and in studying. And I decided to turn my focus point, which I hated my home life, so anything that I could do in school or any activity or club that I could belong to, I would definitely enroll in it. So school to me was a base of escape.
And actually, that ties in pretty well with one of these songs that you've selected, Fly Like an Eagle. Why is that one special to you?
Fly Like an Eagle was, and it still is, a very special song to me because it was a song that I would hear on the radio and I would be able to close my eyes and pretend that I could see the ocean, because you can't see the ocean from Ashe County, of course.
And the lyrics say, I want to fly like an eagle to the sea.
Yes, it says fly like an eagle to the sea. And it was basically a way of being able to escape what the current situation was, though it was just a mental escape. And it's a way of playing pretend, like small children play pretend. And to me, that was some kind of stress relief. So when I would hear that song, it would connect to me, because it's fly like an eagle to the sea, fly like an eagle, let my spirit carry me. And it's basically like you're somewhere physically, but you can imagine that you're somewhere else. So it's mental relief. I believe that the song also goes into talking about clothing people and feeding people. What are the lyrics exactly?
You're right, yeah. Feed the babies who don't have enough to eat. Shoe the children with no shoes on their feet. House the people living in the street. There's a solution.
Yes.
And it talks about a revolution.
And it talks about a revolution. And when I was a child, those lyrics to me meant so much because I was one of those kids. I was one of those kids that was, you know, on the street at some moment in time when we didn't even have electricity, when I didn't have the proper clothes. And that was basically me. So my vision was to be able to help others in the future.
Mama's House being the outgrowth of all that.
Yes, at the age of 45.
Let's hear the song, Fly Like an Eagle, by the Steve Miller Band. That was Fly Like an Eagle by the Steve Miller Band. If you're just joining us, our guest today is Janette Rod. Janette is the founder of a 501c3 organization called Mama's House. And Janette, I'd like to have you tell us a little bit more about how Mama's House operates, but I might note before we get into it that it's clear that you feel very personally about the things that you have already talked about and that we're discussing. I appreciate your sharing your heart with us. Thank you. Let's pick up there with more about Mama's House. You've said twice already that you founded Mama's House when you were 45. Why the emphasis on your age at the time of its founding?
The emphasis on the age is because I feel that I'm way past my half-life point. And I thought if I don't do it at 45, I'm never going to know. And if I keep waiting till I'm older, I won't have the energy or stamina to be able to do this. And if you don't try it, how will you know if you're going to succeed or be a failure? When I was getting ready to open up Mama's House, I struggled greatly with the idea of presenting my background out and in the open to the community. It's something that's very painful to me to discuss and talk about. But thankfully, my youngest son convinced me that I needed to tell my story. And by me telling my story, it's been able to open up to people to come out and share. And it's just very difficult to talk about without getting emotional. Because I'm here to talk about good things and not bad things. And I'm here to talk about hope for people who might be suffering through something that I went through when I was younger.
You certainly understand what it is that they may be dealing with. And in terms of the age, it sounds like it was a now or never sort of thing for you. Is that fair?
That is correct. It was an inner voice that said, you've got to do this now or you're never going to know. You're never going to know your, it was almost like your true purpose. Let's put it that way.
Uh-huh.
If there was a reason that I went through all that struggle and all that suffering, and can you convert that moment in your life, which was my full childhood, into something positive and not leave it as is just something that just happened and you move on and you pretend everything is fine in life. And I just can't turn a blind eye knowing that there's so much need out there.
Well, tell us more about Mama's House, how it operates and what the standards are and just the day-to-day operations.
Well, Mama's House is currently open 7 days a week, and our food bank also runs open 7 days a week. We are there for anyone that needs emergency assistance with either food or clothing on the spot. The families come in, they register, they show their IDs, and we have grown to over 1,600 total headcount of recipients, and more have just been added on now since we just opened up the house. And the idea of the house is not to keep people on there long term, because what I want to do is, number one, give them a push so they don't go into a worser degree of poverty or that they become homeless. That's not what the idea is. The idea is to give them that push to keep them away from becoming homeless and hopefully moving them into a better situation financially. Now, there's also the situations of somebody who maybe just lost their job or someone that became ill and their medical bills are too high and they're trying to make ends meet. Those families also come to us and we also help supplement in whatever it is that they need. I don't have any financial assistance in the house and I don't have any housing that I can give them, but we are working with other local nonprofits for battered women. We have contacts over in social services. We are trying to reach out to Tri-County, which is Wake, Johnston, and Harnett County right now. So we're trying to do the outreach on a Tri-County level.
Is there a thrift shop component to Mama's House?
Yes. So the thrift shop component comes in this way. People donate items to Mama's House. We accept any kind of houseware, toiletries, dried canned food, anything that you have at home that is in good condition, we accept at Mama's House. There's about 10 to 15% of the inventory that's received, be it in housewares or in high-end clothing items that are placed inside the thrift store. With that 10 to 15% that's placed inside the thrift store, we gain the funds to be able to run the food bank. And that's how we have the money to buy the food. The remaining inventory sits in the warehouse. And as families come out, whatever they need, if someone's toaster broke or they need a refrigerator, if I have it, it's given to them for free at no cost when they need it.
I'd like to come back to some of what you've just been talking about. But before we do that, tell us about Caravan of Love.
Caravan of Love is a song for me that basically talks about people in unity, and it's about sharing the love. And one of the mottos over at Mama's House is we welcome everyone with open arms. And I want the families and the people that come to us that have that need to know that you are going to find love there. You are going to find the place that's not going to ask you a million questions about either your background or about your belief or anything like that. I believe that the foundation is formed to do good and to help everyone that is in need. And I want to be able to share that love with the families, because the problem is that people don't understand that when people are going through this need and these horrible situations in their life and these financial crises and whatever else there might be, because there might be drug abuse or alcohol abuse or mental abuse of some kind, or you know, that their spouse hits them, because I meet families that most of them come with other situations, and since they know my background, I can basically I can understand them, and I know. And when we talk on the one-on-one basis, they share this with me, and I try to give them guidance and hope and lead them in the right direction. And that's why Caravan of Love is so important to me, because I try to share the love with all of them.
In a apparently non-judgmental fashion.
Non-judgmental of any kind. There is no judgment at Mama's House.
How did you learn of this song, Caravan of Love?
I heard it on the radio.
Oh, let's hear it for the radio.
All my songs were heard on the radio.
Goes back to 1985, actually. Originally recorded by Marvin and Ernie Isley and their brother Chris Jasper. Tell you what, we'll come back to some more of what you've been talking about, Janette, but let's hear the song, Caravan of Love. That was Caravan of Love by Marvin and Ernie Isley and their brother Chris Jasper. Janette, if people want more information about Mama's House, where can they find it?
They can find it on our website, which is mamashouseofthrift.org.
No apostrophe, I assumed. M-A-M-A-S.
Yes. mamashouseofthrift.org or mamashouseofthrift.com. They can also look us up on their Facebook under Mama's House.
If people are interested in helping in any fashion, you're open to that, I gather?
Yes, absolutely.
What might that look like?
There's different ways of helping out Mama's House, whether if it's volunteering at least an hour every once in a while and helping us either take care of the house or sort donations or help us out in the food bank, even doing food deliveries. That's very helpful. One of the things that we do need is for people to remember that when they come and they shop at Mama's House, for every dollar we get to buy two cans of food. So their support that way is also very needed. The other thing that people can also do is under our mamashouseofthrift.org, they can donate. And currently we have what I call the dollar campaign, which I've gone out to the community asking for a donation of just $1 a month.
Let me shift gears on you a little bit and sort of have you talk big picture here, or maybe bigger picture. We were just listening to Caravan of Love, and listening to those lyrics, it strikes me that there's real idealism represented in that song. And I wonder how you handle sort of personally the division and the angry rhetoric that we find in our society so much right now.
It amazes me that in the year 2020, we, meaning the world, is still divided by politics and by religion. And one of the foundations of Mama's House is that when we work together, we don't discuss any religion and we don't discuss politics of any kind. And that's the way that we keep peace amongst the volunteers. The idea is community, and that's what community is about. Community means accepting everyone that is living within the community, regardless of your background, your religion, or your race, or your status. We're humans, and I think that that is one of the bases right now that the world needs more, which is that humanity factor. We're projecting peace, we're projecting love, and we're projecting goodness to mankind. And that is what I want Mama's House to represent. I want it to represent equality for all.
And the needs that Mama's House is focused on and that you're personally motivated to meet cross generations, they cross racial lines, they cross family lines. There are needs of all sorts, I gather,
regardless
of people's circumstances.
That's right. And we all have the same needs.
What is the extent of the need in your experience? You're talking about the triangle area of North Carolina, which at least from the outside watching world is viewed as a fairly well-to-do part of the country.
Yes, the triangle area, of course, is very well-to-do. But with that, we can't turn a blind eye to what's happening on the outskirts and what's happening within the community. So it's been shocking to me that some people have come to me and have said, I didn't realize that we had homeless people within our community. Mm. And I'm thinking, you just can't go around on a day-to-day basis and keep avoiding the problems. I mean, I understand that, you know, many of us want to live in that perfect world, and our world is beyond imperfect. And we have to open up our eyes to that, because you don't know if you're well off today. And at some moment in time in your life, you'll be on the other end of that stick. Maybe you'll be the person that's going through that need. And one of the things that I believe is very important about Mama's House is that I think that children from a very young age should also learn to be able to service in the community those people in need. I think it's good to establish that in young hearts. And if you look on the Facebook page and you look on the website, we have many groups of young volunteers that come out. I believe our youngest volunteer right now is 2 years old. And I love the idea that the parents can bring in the children and teach them that it's good for them to do good deeds for others that are in need, because it exposes the children not to be unknowing that there is poverty and there is a need within the area. I think that that helps mentor and teach the children. It basically expands their knowledge. And I think that we should all be knowledgeable in different areas, because the more knowledge that we have, the better that we can fortify and build our communities. We need to make them stronger. It's not to let the poor continue being poor and just shove them to the side. How about let's help them for them not to continue being poor? Let's help stop the homelessness. Let's help them move forward so maybe they can turn into middle class, you know? And if you do that, that makes your community stronger.
Let me ask you, Janette, by way of wrap up, are you optimistic?
Well, I think that that's one of the things that I've always had is optimism. And optimism comes hand in hand with hope. You have to have hope, and then with hope comes faith, right? You have to have that as some kind of basis, because if not, life is not worth living. And if you're put here, you have to have a reason. You have to have a purpose. And I believe that everyone has a purpose and a meaning, some kind, within this world, within your period of time that you're here. My optimism is that as long as the community supports Mama's House, as long as people can see the vision, as long as we can move forward without barriers of religion or politics or anything like that, then maybe this can work, you know? And it's just an idea that I came up with. So far, it's been successful, and the community is latching onto it, and people like the transparency idea, and people like to be able to be hands-on helping others. That is what I have noticed. And they like to be able to donate and know that that towel, that mattress, that can of food is going to someone. And that's why I like for volunteers to come out and participate 7 days a week. If they want to see the way that the foundation runs, if they want to see what we do in our charity, I'm open to anyone at any time.
It occurs to me that in hearing about your hope, your optimism, that maybe John Lennon and Yoko Ono have been whispering in your ear. Tell us about this song that we're going to wrap up with, Imagine.
The song Imagine. The song Imagine is a song for me that basically breaks down any barrier. It's also a song that I know that for many years it's been controversial to certain people. But once you move past the controversy of the song and decide let go of that religious barrier and let go of that political barrier, it makes us all human. And I believe that what John and Yoko were trying to bring was the idea of unity and peace, making everyone realize we're human, we're flesh and blood. So once you go down to it, and you know, we're bone inside, it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter what race or what religion, we all have the same need. We all need shelter. We all need food. We need to be taken care of. We can't be suffering in danger constantly. And I think that that was the beauty of that song. And I live by that song. That song represents me.
You told me before we came into the studio that you're one of those dreamers.
I am a dreamer. I am one of John Lennon's dreamers. And I hope that someday, like he says, that it can be real, that we no longer have to dream it, that we could do it.
Janette, it's been a real privilege, a real treat to have you here. Thank you for joining us today.
Thank you for having me here.
Let's hear the song, Imagine, by John Lennon and Yoko Ono.